Hey, what's up guys? In this video, I want to show you a holster I got for a government size 1911. I do find this holster here, which is inside the waistband, to be one of the better types of holsters to be able to conceal a full-size government 1911. So without further ado, let's talk about this holster. This holster is made by Milt Sparks. Okay, and before I go on, I just want to say, I find Milt Sparks to be one of the best holster makers out there. I've said this before. And I've been using their holster since, I don't know, 2000 up till now, 2015, so 15 years. And there are two things that have never changed about Milt Sparks: their quality and their lead times. It never fails. Their lead times are quite long. So if you want one of these, you got to be patient. I know, what is it, like 6 years ago? I remember the lead time was like 6 months or 8 months. That's pretty crazy. But when you get the holster, you're going to tell yourself, I'm glad I waited. 6 to 8 months is kind of ridiculous, but I think their lead time right now is just about 3 months. So guys, if you really want one of their model holsters, set it and forget it. Order one, okay? They don't charge the credit card until they start making it, I guess. And you'll be glad after it's made and sent to you that you waited, because their quality is bar none, really. They have some of the best leather holsters out there. This Milt Sparks holster is the VersaMax 2. And like I said, it's made for a government size 1911. I think this is one of the best inside the waistband holsters for a 1911. It's the best way to conceal a 1911. Now, I used to use the Summer Special 2 back in the day, and that worked out pretty well, but I think this one right here works out even better because of the way it distributes the weight of that heavy 1911 pistol. And I've been using VersaMax 2 for a long time, for years. And so this is no stranger to me, but I just wanted to kind of quickly share my thoughts with you guys on this holster right here. So if you're gonna carry 1911, I do find that, let's just make safe with this. Gotta crack it open like this still, because it's still tight. I do find that this holster right here is probably the better one, in the sense that, well, let's just put this in here. We'll holster up. In the sense that it distributes the weight evenly. And this is more of a 4 o'clock position holster because it has the FBI cant, so it's like that. So a 4 o'clock position behind the hip, and with a good gun belt, if you ratchet it down, it's gonna tug in that grip like that, right into your body. And that's what we really need to conceal, is this grip. Even with a plain old t-shirt, if you were to get this at the 4 o'clock position and tuck it in, it still will print. You know, this grip right here will still print if you bend over, bend down, what have you. But how many people are going to know what that print is? So this will go right in the waistband inside. It's pretty good, and because of the 1911's flat profile, it works out very well. You know, it's not like the pug nose with the 8-shot cylinder that's real fat. Stuffing that in the pants, yeah, that can prove uncomfortable and sometimes intolerable. But something like this, very tolerable, works out very well. Flat profile of the 1911, 4 o'clock position, grip tucks right into your body, and it conceals very well. So I think this is a great inside the waistband holster. If you want to conceal carry full government size 1911, this is probably be the way to go. However, there's a lot of other options out there, and you guys can leave them in the comments below. What type of holster would you recommend for a government size 1911 inside the waistband? There's so many of them, but I like the VersaMax 2. I know there's other companies out there like Galco and, you know, maybe DeSantis. These are the cookie cutter holster companies that have kind of copied this concept right here. I mean, there's a lot of people have used this concept, you know, it's nothing new, but I do find the concept of having two loops, such as like this, like that, a better way to carry a heavier pistol, per se. And it works out just fine with a 1911. It does have this sweat guard shield right here to protect the side safety so you don't disengage it unintentionally. So it's like that. I just wanted to add that this does have a metal band sewn in right here to keep the mouth from collapsing. So that's pretty good. Other than that, these snaps right here are pretty nice. I haven't had any issues with the snaps coming undone upon drawing. You know, sometimes if I'm doing an aggressive draw, I would be worried about if one of these snaps just to pop off, or both of them, then you'd be in some big trouble. But no, they're extremely stable, so they're not doing that. Holster is nicely finished. Just no sharp edges anywhere here. Yeah, nicely finished. And the actual detail of the actual holster here, like the detail if you want to call it boning, I guess, is pretty nice. Stitched really nicely. It's a high quality holster, guys. And I guess that's all I really wanted to talk to you guys about. I think this is horse hide, so it might, you know, repel sweat a little bit better. But it is a quality leather inside the waistband holster. Milt Sparks. Definitely worth the wait if you can find one readily available. I mean, they do have them readily available for the 1911 just because it's so common. You might be paying, you know, it's pricey, but again, it is worth the money. I really honestly feel their holsters are worth the money and the wait for these. So, hey, why don't we just kind of check out what this looks like on my person so you guys can, you know, just see kind of how it conceals and stuff like that. Hey, look at this stamp here. That's pretty cool. I think that's their anniversary stamp. Yeah. All right, anyways. Let's check it out. Sorry about that. I just was kind of intrigued by that stamp. All right, let's check it out. Hold on. All right, so I have the VersaMax 2 on my person right now on the strong side. It's about 4 o'clock position. It's behind the hip. All right, it's behind the hip. And it's inside the waistband. Just to kind of give you an idea what it looks like inside the waistband, I've got 2 belt loops like that, securing the holster, and it's evenly distributing the weight of this full stainless steel government size 1911. And it hugs right into the body, guys, and it feels pretty good. It does feel pretty good. Now, if you're just using a t-shirt to conceal this 1911, the grip, because it's you know, it's a full size grip, will print through the shirt if you're bending or twisting. So that's up to you guys. I mean, how many people are gonna understand that print right there? Probably not a lot. So, but I just want to show you what this looks like. Strong side, behind the hip, 4 o'clock position. Looks like that. And to draw, basically, comes out very, you know, very easy. Reholster one-handed, not a problem. The mouth does not close up, but that's it. And it fits perfectly. So guys, this is a great inside the waistband holster. If you want to carry a full-size 1911, you can do it with this. And it works out. Now, if I want to conceal it with the shirt, basically what I was saying before, all right, if it's like this, it is tucked in to my body, but if you start bending and twisting, you know, you can see that grip right there. So if you wanted to get a patterned shirt, I said this before, like a type of patterned shirt, that's gonna help break up that print pretty good. So a black t-shirt or stripes and boxes and, you know, stuff going on, it'll break up that print where that grip is kind of printing. So, but other than that, you could conceal a, you know, government size 1911 just like this if you had to. So there you go, guys. Let me know what you think about all this. VersaMax 2 made by Milt Sparks. All right, guys, as always, stay safe and check 360 often. Later.